In this video, I will teach you how to mod sounds and music in Age of Empires 2 Definitive Edition from scratch. First, I will go through how to install the required software applications, and then I will go through how to make a mod which replaces the game's audio files with your own. You can browse the parts of this tutorial video at any time from the playback timeline or the video description. This is a step-by-step tutorial walkthrough video. And the video is not realistically slow enough to leave running for the whole process, since loading times and the like are cut out. So if you are following it from start to finish, you might find it easier to pause it every few steps to execute them yourself, and then resume the video when you are ready for the next steps. We need two applications, Audacity and Wwise. Audacity will enable us to capture and create the exact sound we want, and Wwise will convert it to the required file format for the game. Open your web browser and go to www.audacityteam.org/download. Then click Download for Windows under the Download Audacity headline. Run the downloaded executable, click Yes if prompted by user account control. Select another language if you want and click OK. Click Next 4 times until the next button turns into an Install button, then click Install. Click Next again, then click Finish. Audacity should now be installed and opened. Click OK on any update or welcome pop-ups. Now for Wwise. Return to your web browser and go to www.audiokinetic.com/download. Then click Download Audio Kinetic Launcher. This will require you to register an account with an email address. Click Create Account, then enter your email address, create a password, then click Create Account. After that, go to the inbox of the email you entered, open the validation request email from Audio Kinetic, and click the Verify Account button. Audio Kinetic will then require you to enter a first name, last name, job type, organization name, organization size, country, and also re-enter the password you created for the account. Once you have entered the requested information and clicked the Create Account button, you should be logged in. If no file is downloaded automatically, click the Click here to start the download manually link. Then run the executable you just downloaded. Click Yes if prompted, click I agree. Click Wwise in the sidebar to the left. Click Install, log in with your Audio Kinetic account, click Next, click Install, click Accept, click Yes if prompted, then click Launch Wwise. Click Accept, click New, name your project, click OK, click Close. We have now installed and opened the programs we need and are ready to process the sounds we want. If you already have the sound you want in a WAV file, you can skip ahead to the WEM conversion part. If you have the sound you want in an audio file of a different format, open Audacity and File Explorer. Locate your sound in the File Explorer, then drag and drop it into Audacity. If you don't have the sound you want in a file yet, locate it from any source which will allow you to play back the sound. Let's say for instance that the sound is in a YouTube video. Go to the YouTube video your sound is in.
What the hell is it? Given time to taste your own medicine.
Pause just before the sound you want, then go back to Audacity. If you don't already have the device's toolbar open, click View, then Toolbar, then Enable Device Toolbar. In the leftmost drop-down menu, select Windows WAS API. Then for Input Device, choose the loopback of your output device. If you're not sure which device is your output device, you can double-check this by right-clicking the sound icon on the right end of the Windows taskbar and clicking Open Sound Settings. The output device should then display for you on the top of the window. Now click the record button, then play back the video from where you paused it.
Fuck, man.
Pause it again when you want the sound to end. Then return to Audacity and click the stop button. Select the recorded dead space and access by left-clicking and dragging in the middle of the track timeline. Then press Delete to erase it. Play back to confirm it is the sound you want by clicking over the track timeline. Once you are happy with the sound, click File, then Export as WAV. Name the file, change the output directory if you wish to, and then click Save. Click OK. In Wwise, click Project, then Import Audio Files. Audio Files, navigate to the directory of your sound, then select your sound and click Open. Then click Import. Before we convert our sound, we need to ensure that the conversion settings are correct. Click Project, then Project Settings, then Source Settings, then dot 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 under Default Conversion Settings. Under Factory Conversion Settings, go to Wwise, then select Wwise Quality High. Click OK, click OK. Now click Project again, then Convert All Audio Files. Click Convert. In the File Explorer, navigate to Wwise Projects under Documents, then your project folder, then .cache, then Windows, then SFX, and here is your sound in a ready format for the game. You can only capture and export WAV files one sound at a time with Audacity, but with Wwise you can import and convert several files simultaneously. Now we have all the necessary files we need for the mod. Next, we are going to create and publish the mod. Open a new instance of File Explorer. Navigate to your Windows username folder, then click Games, Age of Empires 2DE, the profile number of your account, Mods, and Local. Create a new folder in this directory and name it for what you want your mod to be named. Now we have a mod shell, but we need to know two things in order to make this a working mod. The directory structure of the modded files, and the names of the files we want to mod. The easiest way to find out these things is to install an existing sound mod. In the game, search and install a mod similar to the one you're about to create. Once you have installed the mod, open the third instance of File Explorer and navigate to your mods folder, but go to the subscribe folder instead of the local folder. Then open the folder of the mod you just installed. Have the folder of your empty mod shell open next to it in the second instance of File Explorer. Copy and paste the contained folder from the example mod to your own mod. Then close the window of the example mod. In your mod folder, navigate to the files inside all the folders. Then move your own sound file there. Rename your own sound to comply with the correct naming scheme, and replace any correlating files you want to replace with it. Delete any unwanted leftover files from the example mod. Now we have created our mod. It's time to test that it's working in the game. In the game, go to Mods, uninstall the example mod if you don't want to keep it, then navigate to the My Mods tab. Click Import Local Mods, navigate back to Installed Mods and check that your mod is enabled. Then restart the game and test to confirm that your mod is working. Now it's time to publish our newly created mod so that others can also enjoy it and so that we can have it even if we are playing on a different PC. Go to the My Mods tab in Mod Manager in the game client. You will need to be logged in with your Microsoft account in order to publish mods. Select your mod and click Publish Mod. Give it a helpful description, then click Publish Now. While it is possible to publish mods in the game client, I find it much more reliable to use the website. Return to your web browser and go to ageofempires.com. Then click Mods and then click Submit a Mod. Sign in with your Microsoft account, enter the name of your mod and create a helpful description. Choose H2DE and check Relevant Category Tag. If you publish the mod with the website, you are required to submit an image file for the mod thumbnail. Submit one if you already have it. Otherwise, you can take a screenshot of anything you deem relevant. Go to Paint, paste the screenshot, select what you want to be the image, click Crop, then save the image and close Paint. Upload that image for the mod. Scroll down to Zip File Upload. Return to your mod folder in the File Explorer, right-click the Resources folder. Click Send To, then Compressed Zip Folder. Drag and drop this zip folder into the drop field, marked by the dotted line. Click Submit. It might take a minute or two for your mod to become available. Your sound mod should now be published and available for download. In summary, capture your sound to WAV format using Audacity, then convert it to WEM format with Wwise. Create your mod as a folder in the local mods folder. Create the needed directory for the modded sounds and move your sound file to it. Make sure it has the correct naming. For reference of required directory and naming, install a similar existing mod. Import and enable the mod in the game. Restart the game client and test that the mod works. Publish the mod using either the game client or the website. While you can usually check with a similar existing mod to find out the directory and file naming you need, These are the common ones for many sound mods for reference. And that's it for this tutorial. You should now know how to mod sounds in Age of Empires 2 Definitive Edition. Let me know in the comment section down below if you have any questions or remarks. If you found this useful, don't forget the like button. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.